Hello everybody, this is Isaac Ashby from Steam Thinkers, and welcome to today's tutorial slash challenge, which is the Hoop Glider Challenge. Now, many of you may have probably never heard of the Hoop Glider, so let me show you what a Hoop Glider is. It is a strange looking thing. It is really simple to make and actually flies really well. So this is what we are going to be make. This is what we're going to be making today. Coming at ya. They're really simple to make and we can have them done in about 5 minutes. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. All we need to do this project is clear tape, scissors, a straw, and a 3x5 card. You like my sweet gesturing with my awesome hands? I should be a hand model. Anyway, so let's get started. First off, you need to take your 3x5 card and you need to cut it into 3 strips lengthwise. So let's take our scissors and we are going to cut 3 roughly equal strips. If they're not equal, that's okay. No problemo. It'll still work. And I have a little shaving there. Okay. I'm going to clean up my... I missed when I... There we go. Okay, so now we've got one strip. Now let's do 2 more. And I'm just going to split this one right down the middle. Like I said, it's no big deal if they don't match. Okay, so now we have 3 strips. Now all we need to do is tape them together. So I'm going to find the 2 strips because it's hard to get all 3 of them the same size. I'm going to find the 2 strips that are closest in size, which looks like these 2, or the closest in width, I should say. And I am going to tape those together. Oh, my tape stuck together. The dangers of working with clear tape. So when I mean tape them together is I am going to overlap them maybe a half an inch or so something. And I am going to put a piece of tape just like so. And this little edge of tape doesn't want to cut down, so I'm just doesn't want to cooperate. So there we go. Next, I am going to make a circle just like this, and I'm going to tape here. So I need another piece of tape. Once again, overlapping about somewhere around a half of an inch. Ah, what are you doing, tape? Come on, son. Just like that, so that we have a hoop or a circle, whatever you want to call it. Then with this last piece, we are going to also make a little circle, a little mini baby circle, as my kids would say. Because everything big is a mommy or daddy and everything small is a little baby. So we're going to have a little baby. Just like that. Okay, so you try to make it as round as possible, just like that. So now we have a straw and 2 circles. Let's hook those together. So we're going to take our tape, we're going to tape. I like to tape it on the seam and tape it at the end of the straw, at least for this one. You're going to get the chance to make more of these as part of your challenge. Okay, so he's taped on just like that. Now you want to tape, and you want him to be kind of straight. Mine went on a little crooked, so I'm going to just kind of play with it. There we go. Okay, it's a little better. Now we want to tape the big one on to the same side of the straw, like the same face. So that they're like this one's on top here, and we want this one on top here. If and that makes sense. Sometimes it's easier to put the tape on the straw first and then attach but however you see fit. Okay, just like that, right? So that when you look down, and mine's still a little looser than I like, I'm just adjusting mine just a bit so that they're on the same face. Sometimes if the hoops are a little loose, you can take a little piece of tape and stick it on the top here. Just like that, and then down like that. Okie dokie. There, now it's much more sturdy. So now we have our hoop glider. All right, now that you have made an official hoop glider and are ready to fly them, why don't you go outside and give it a toss? To fly them, hold them right in the middle with the hoops up, pull your arm back and throw them forward. Try to make sure that your arm is, or that the hoop glider is going straight rather than going like this. Like some people will arc their arm when they throw them and then they crash into the ground. So you want like you're throwing darts towards a dartboard. Okay? So why don't you go give that a try and come back and we'll see what happened. All right, did they fly? Was that the most amazing thing you've ever seen in your whole entire life? I hope so. I know they're simple and they're easy, but there's a lot of cool things that you can do with them. You can have races, you can go through obstacle courses, you can throw them at each other. The possibilities are endless. You can make cookies with them. Okay, I know that's kind of weird. Who would make cookies with a hoop glider? But anyways, now for a little information on how things fly. Because these things, they don't look like they would fly, right? There are four forces that affect something that flies, right? Four forces. First one, what happens when you drop something? Gravity. Now, did this thing fly? No, because it's missing two of the other forces, right? It's missing two of the other forces. So gravity takes over and will make something fall to the ground. It pulls things down towards the earth. Number two, the second thing that affects them is lift. Lift is the opposing force that goes against gravity, like what I'm doing now. I'm lifting my hoop glider into the air. So are you saying that there's an invisible hand lifting airplanes and everything that flies into the sky? Absolutely not. What we're talking about here is a principle that helps to overcome gravity. Let's talk about it this way. Have you ever been in a car and you're speeding along the highway and you're begging your mom to roll down the windows or let you roll down the windows so that you can stick your arm out? Because what do? You stick your arm out the window and you like to surf. Oh yeah, surf. Surf's up, man. Right? Your hands going up and down in the waves. Well, on the up cycle, you are creating lift because when those air molecules hit your hand, it forces your hand up, right? When you tip your hand up, your hand wants to go up and back. And when you tip it down, it wants to go down. So that is lift. It's called the angle of attack, the tilt. And this is kind of playing around with the angle of attack is one of the reasons why it flies. The third thing that there's two more forces. So these are the up and down forces. Now we got to deal with the back and forth forces. We've got thrust. Thrust is in all those engines pushing those airplanes forward, right? It's the gasoline that combusts in the engine and pushes a jet forward through space. That is thrust. Now, what is that? Do these have jet engines? No. The thrust is coming with your hand. You're putting all your energy into throwing just with your hand. So that is thrust. And the opposing force would be friction. And friction, or excuse me, drag is another name for friction, but when you're talking about airplanes, you usually talk about it as calling it drag. So with drag, those the fr that's basically friction of all the air molecules running into your hand. So when you have thrust going forward or energy moving it forward, and you have friction, and you give that angle attack, that gives you lift. So that's what's happening with our little hoop gliders. I know it's really hard to see because it doesn't have wings, but now comes the challenge. Because this thing can fly, can you make something that flies that's similar to this? What add-ons or what changes can you make? What happens if you were to make your little circles into ovals or flatten them out completely and make wings? Would it fly as well as this? So that's your challenge. I want you to make at least one more of these, but the more the merrier, because I want you to learn something, is I want you to mess around and try to understand what things fly and what things don't. So try adding extra wings, try adding tail fins, try doing all sorts of stuff just to see what design you can make that flies the furthest. So your challenge is to make a hoop glider and change it, and to see if you can make one that flies further than this. Are you up for the challenge? So I know you're up for the challenge. It'll be a lot of fun. Make as many as you need, as many as you have materials for, and as many as your mom will let you make, because who's really in charge here, right? So have fun and enjoy the hoop gliders. This is Isaac Ashby from Steam Thinkers, and we will see you later, kids. Bye.